In this video, we're going to review Samsung's the premier LSP9T 4K laser projector, which provides almost full coverage of Rec.2020 color space, surpassing even reference mastering monitors. Keep watching. Hello everyone, Vincent Liu from HDTV Test here. The most important thing you need to know about the Samsung LSP9T, the premier projector, is that it is equipped with a triple laser RGB light source, as you can see from the spectral power distribution, showing almost monochromatic wavelengths of the red, green, and blue colors. And this in turn actually provides an extremely wide color gamut, and Rec.2020 coverage is 98%. And this is the largest that we've actually measured on a consumer display. And if we turn to DCI-P3 color gamut coverage, you can see that it will cover 99% of DCI-P3 as well. Now, the thing with such a wide color gamut is actually quite, you know, counterintuitive in a sense, because, you know, that will mean that the colors are going to be slightly inaccurate because no current mastering monitor can achieve Rec.2020 coverage yet. And therefore, when we look at a color checker SG chart, where 140 patches were measured, you can see that we had difficulty trying to rein in the colors and make them adhere to not only Rec.709 but also DCI-P3 in terms of the accuracy. And therefore, some of the colors will look overblown, oversaturated. But I think, you know, if you don't have a reference monitor, you may like this slightly more vibrant and more vivid colors. But I think, you know, if accuracy is your thing, it is very difficult to use this Samsung the premier projector as a benchmark. Despite that, I think, you know, the triple color laser does have its advantages in that, you know, because you are using a triple laser without any color wheel, without using any color filter to achieve this sort of white color gamut, you can still get really bright and intensely colorful images. And this is one of the appeal of the Samsung LSP90 projector. And I think HDR images, they not only look bright, they also look really colorful as well. And this combination gives a really strong HDR impact that pops off the screen, as much as I've actually seen from a consumer projector. This ultra short throw laser projector is equipped with a 0.66 inch DLP chip from Texas Instruments. That is quite impressive in the sense that I think the contrast and the black levels are probably the deepest that I've actually seen from any ultra short throw projector. But of course, you know, if you want to benchmark it against JVC's front projectors, then, you know, there is just no competition. But those are not ultra short throw projectors, and I think ultra short throw projectors these days, you know, try to fulfill a function of trying to replace the television, and therefore, you know, they can actually go very bright. And because of the ultra short throw form factor, you get not that much of a light loss, and therefore you can actually still get a pretty watchable picture in a room with some ambient lighting. Next, what we'll talk about would be the motion, and I think that the motion on this projector is going to be quite problematic for those of you who want accurate 24 frames per second reproduction, because this projector is inherently 60Hz centric and therefore it can't reproduce 24p motion natively without some sort of telecinetic judder, and therefore you are forced to use judder reduction on the Samsung projector to try and smooth out the motion. But the moment you do that, you will be introducing some frame interpolation, and therefore you may be incurring some interpolation artifacts and also some soap opera effect, however mild. And the other thing with this projector is obviously it is sold in the UK, and it is sold with a satellite tuner and also a digital freeview tuner as well. But because the projector is 60Hz centric, 50Hz broadcast will have to go through some sort of frame rate conversion, and therefore you may see some stuttering until you again have to engage picture clarity or judder reduction to try and smooth them out. And because this projector is not 120Hz, when it comes to motion resolution, it is always going to be capped at the sampling hole baseline of 300 lines, regardless of what you do to the picture clarity settings. And I think that there are a few things that I need to talk about in terms of the laser light source. So the uniformity is very good, you know, by any projectors or standards. I think, you know, if you are seeing some sort of scan lines here and there throughout this review video, it is because of the refresh rate of the projector and a mismatch with my camera. So those are actually not visible in person. But another thing about this laser projector is that in very bright scenes, you may be able to see some very fine speckle shimmer of almost like film grain, but it is not film grain that is present in the content itself. It is actually introduced by the laser. But I think, you know, it is not something that I would be concerned of unless you are sitting quite close to the screen. And another thing about the triple laser implementation on this Samsung the Premier LSP9T projector is that it is prone to slight chromatic aberration from the lens, in that the pixels are not actually perfectly aligned in terms of the red, green and blue. But I think from a normal viewing distance, it is going to be not very visible, at least on my review sample. This video is sponsored by Box, the online technology store. Visit box.co.uk for the best deals on TVs, soundbars, and all your other technology needs. Upscaling is very good. I always like Samsung's upscaling. It is very forgiving, you know, it retrieves nice detail without excessive ringing or fizziness. And when it came to video-based interlacing, again, Samsung's jaggy suppression is one of the best, if not the best in the business. It suppresses jagged edges in this bouncing bar test pattern from the HQV benchmark disc very nicely. In terms of film mode deinterlacing, this projector correctly detected 3:2 cadence, but it failed 2:2 cadence, and even 3:2 cadence in 1080i was a fail as well. So I think, you know, if you are sending an interlaced video signal to this projector, you might want to reconsider and ask your source device to do the deinterlacing so that, you know, you send a progressive signal to this projector for the best picture quality. I've touched very briefly earlier about HDR, and I really like the HDR presentation from this projector because of the combination of the quite high brightness, which is again not needing any color filter to achieve wider color gamut. So you get a combination of high brightness and really vibrant colors at the same time. But I think the tone mapping on this projector doesn't have the dynamic tone mapping on JVC's DILA projectors. And so depending on the metadata of the film and what sort of level it is mastered at, you know, you have to lower the contrast to retrieve a bit more specular highlight detail. In terms of 10-bit native gradation, as with most Samsung displays, there will be some posterization in smooth gradients, for example, in this panning shot from the Martian. And also surrounding bright elements, there will be some posterization. Now, this can be reduced by engaging color space native, which is necessary to achieve the widest color gamut, 98% of Rec.2020 that this projector is capable of anyway. But just bear in mind that, you know, you are not getting accurate colors. You can also choose to switch to BT2020. Which will again reduce the posterization. Input lag in game mode measured 55 milliseconds, which is higher than most Samsung TVs that we have measured. And I think this projector also supports auto low latency mode, but I think most hardcore gamers probably will be turning to other displays for playing reflex-based games. With this out of the way, let's talk about the design of the projector. The projector is only available in a white finish, which fortunately doesn't show up that many fingerprints. But I think, you know, the reason why Samsung and many other ultra short throw laser projectors have gone with a white finish is because they are meant to be used in a brighter environment. And the front of the projector has the speakers, which is covered in quadrat acoustically transparent cloth, and the connections are found on the rear of the unit, and there are three HDMI 2.0b ports, one of which is the eARC port, and there is also a white remote control supplied with the projector with very few buttons, but I think, you know, it is very usable and just feels quite good to hold in the hand. And I think one thing to mention is that, you know, there are obviously side vents on the projector, but this projector is very, very quiet, you know, by the standards of any projector, and there is no coil wind whatsoever. And I think that the triple laser engine certainly helps with not having a color wheel, and therefore this projector, I feel extremely comfortable using it, you know, even with low volumes from the projector. The background noise certainly won't spoil your viewing experience. Now, of course, you know, if you engage high altitude mode on the projector, then the fan noise will go up. So unless, you know, you are staying in a really high place, I don't think you should engage high altitude mode anyway. And within the menu itself, you know, electronic focus is provided, which is fantastic. And as with most ultra short throw laser projectors, there is no zoom control, so you have to physically place a projector close to the screen to enlarge the projected image. But there are some screen adjustments provided by Samsung where you can adjust 4 points, or more precise 15 points. But I think, you know, when it comes to this sort of geometric correction, I feel that it will always degrade the image, however slightly, so I try to keep them to a minimum. And I think when it came to the menu system, it feels very much like a Samsung television. And that is a good thing, because I think the collection of smart TV apps that have been provided on this projector is very comprehensive. You get Netflix, you get Amazon Prime Video, BBC iPlayer, Disney Plus, Apple TV, YouTube. A lot, really. And obviously the smart hub is very accessible and easy to use as well. Last but not least, let's talk about the sound. And I think most people who buy this sort of projector may have their own home theater solution which will provide beefier sound, but I was genuinely quite impressed with the sound output from this projector. I think, you know, it is certainly one of the best in-projector sound that I've heard from any projector, period. And I think, you know, many of you will be satisfied with it unless you go one step up to a home theater solution. To sum up, Samsung's the premier LSP9T laser projector is probably the best ultra short throw laser projector on the market today that I've actually tested. I mean, it is not without its shortcomings. I think the color accuracy leaves a lot to be desired, and I think that, you know, its motion is hampered by the 60Hz centric design of the DLP chipset. But when you consider the supremely wide color gamut that this projector is capable of, you know, the bright and punchy HDR images, the quiet operation, and I would say class-leading sound quality, it earns our recommended award. To watch more of our technical projector reviews, please click here for our playlist, and I'll see you in the next video.